My teaching career first started when I was a little girl, wanted to be a teacher or a nurse or a hospital administrator. So teaching anatomy and physiology kind of gets the vibe for medical things, but also being in charge. And then I moved into teaching anatomy and physiology for 6 years and then moved to Texas and have been here for 24 years doing the same. My favorite part about teaching anatomy and physiology is getting to spend all day with teenagers who have the same interests that I do. Teenagers are my favorite people on planet Earth, and the medical-minded ones are, we just have a common bond, and we think the same things are funny, and they're interested in learning what I also love, and so we just have a good day every day. My favorite unit to teach is probably the skeletal system. It's the first unit that we go very in-depth in the human body. My students are required to learn all 206 bones of the body, and many of them think that that's a daunting task, but the test scores are incredibly high, and I think it's the first time that they realize they can do more than they think they can. And so for that academic confidence part, is probably why it's my favorite unit to teach. The most important part of my class, in my opinion, is for my students just to trust the system. I've been teaching anatomy and physiology a long time, and I know what it takes for students to get to the point of being confident and know all the things. And so if I ask them to do homework assignments, if I ask them to do Canvas quizzes, if we do a lab a certain time period in the unit, there's a reason for all of it. And so if they will just trust the system and do all the things that I'm asking them to do, they're gonna wind up doing really, really well in the class.
Is the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo. It gives students in the Houston area an opportunity to one, have their artwork shown, and two, have opportunity to earn scholarship money. The teachers, we make it part of the assignment. There's rules that the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo put out, so we have to abide by those rules. Has to be Western in theme, has to be original photos and things like that. So the students are able to draw or paint or sculpt, depending on what class that they're in, using and abiding by the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo rules. There wasn't any rules changes from last year. Really the only thing that Conroe ISD did was when we have our district show, we made the high school students 9th through 12th. We put that in the show so the community could see the sculptures, but they're judged separately by Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo. And then if they're a finalist, we take those pieces down to NRG and those get competed against all the other finalists in the Houston area. I think all of my students did really good. I had four finalists. So I'm really proud of them for doing that. One student in particular had some problems working through it, but she got it done and it ended up being a finalist. So I'm proud of her for that.
I was really excited. I like jumped up. I saw my seventh grade teacher as well, so I jumped into her arms and like my mom was crying and I was really excited. I didn't think I would finalize. Trust the process. Just trust it and like, just find as much motivation as you can. Just work through it. Just keep working on it.
HOSA is a student-led organization for students in the health science program. We compete against other schools. We do community service events. Primarily, we do the Oak Ridge blood drives, one in the fall and one in the spring. And then there are scholarship opportunities, and students who go on to college can also join HOSA in college. So it's basically a student-led career and technical student organization for the students in the health science program at Oak Ridge High School.
We have guest speakers show up, and that's the opportunity for the members of HOSA to learn about the different careers you can do. We've had ranges from the IT who work at Memorial Hermann. We've also had cardiologists in the past. So it's really a wide range of all the people that work in the hospital.
We want to do things that are going to help enrich the students, developing that sense of competitiveness, as well as try to reach out and help the community. And also we focus on competition. Right now preparing to go to the Spring Leadership Conference at the end of this week to compete against other schools in this entire Houston area. There's probably 80-something number of competitive events, everything from knowledge-based events where you're just competing, you know, on a knowledge basis, and then there's skill-based, students doing certain skills like medical assisting and clinical nursing and things like that. There are events for people to participate in.
I feel that my greatest challenge in HOSA, honestly, is preparing for the competition. I feel like once you get there, you're a little nervous, but you do it and then you're done. But I feel the preparedness that you do before, I feel like that's tough because you have to really work to get a good product to be able to show the judges. What I plan to do with my HOSA experience is my leadership. Really working with others is very important. As much leadership that I've grown this past year, I feel that I can really use in the future whenever I become in a higher, upper leadership role. I feel that people should join HOSA, especially if you have an interest in healthcare, even just a tad bit of interest, you'll be able to learn more in HOSA than if you don't join it. And I very much recommend doing the competitions because that's, I feel, you will get more experience doing.
I encourage students, if they plan on going into the healthcare field in the future, I highly encourage them to be a part of HOSA. It allows them to compete against other like-minded students, but also there are a lot of college organizations that they can join, and they could put it on their college applications and stuff, so it's just overall a good experience, and it's highly recommended for all the students in health science in Conroe ISD.
Best genre of music, in my opinion, is a rock, six, like all decades type of rocks, low-key. Maybe a little bit of jazz in there too, like jazz.
80s rock and just, I say old country music.
Well, I say rap.
I say rap as well.
R&B, definitely for sure.
Best artist in my opinion? This might be basic, but Kendrick Lamar.
Ozzy Osbourne.
Either Key Glock or Moneybagg Yo.
Ooh. I'm gonna say Big X the Plug. Yeah.
Daniel Caesar, he's really good.
Hokey, either Ice Spice or Playboi Carti.
Kane Brown.
We're leaving Sexy Red in 23, dude. we're leaving Sexy Red in 23.
Yeah, I'd probably say her.
Sexy Red.
Yeah.
Yeet, please, can we just leave him, bro?
Biggest rise this year? I hope either Lil Uzi or Lil Yachty.
Motley Crue. Listen to some Motley Crue. Yeah.
Ooh.
Big X of Blood. Big X of Blood,
baby. Baby Tron.
I mean, Travis Scott was last year, but like, I think he's just gonna like keep rising this year for sure.
He's kind of popping off a little bit, named Malcolm Todd. Check him out. He does a little bit of like, a little bit R&B, a little bit of like Steve Lacy type stuff.
Daniel Caesar, for sure.
I'd say Dangerous by Key Glock, that's a good one.
Dangerous by Key Glock. I'm gonna just say every song by Big X of Plug. He's just cold.